The International Commission of Jurists is accusing the state of using the National Intelligence Service, NIS, to undermine the independence of the judiciary. ICJ claims to have received numerous complaints that staff as well as personnel closely associated with NIS are intimidating judicial staff during adjudication of or after the delivery of verdicts. Ben Troy-Njue is with that report.
The International Commission of Jurists is now demanding that the National Intelligence Service responds to allegations of intimidation and recommend prosecution of those found culpable.
To intimidate by either stealthily following, tapping their telephones, or recording through other means the movements of judicial officers and judges. It is meant to threaten, intimidate, and harass so that the independence of the judiciary is compromised.
In a letter sent to the Director General of the National Intelligence Service and copied to the Chief Justice, ICJ Kenya Chapter Chairman Kevin Mogeni said judicial independence is critical in maintaining the integrity of the judiciary and judges should feel free to deliver decisions without external pressures.
Judges at all times must be free to fairly evaluate the matters before them based on the evidence presented to them and the relevant law secure from external pressures. The independence of the judiciary in particular, its decisional independence, is provided for in most jurisdictions and entrenched in our constitutional and normative frameworks.
Citing President Uhuru Kenyatta's decision to decline appointing judges recommended by the Judicial Service Commission and the High Court and Court of Appeal decision to stop the Building Bridges Initiative constitutional amendment process.
We wish to remind the executive that the Constitution guarantees the independence of the judiciary and specifically it insulates the institution from control directions of any person or authority.
The Commission said any queries or concerns regarding judges and magistrates should be channeled through the Judicial Service Commission.
We wish to invite the National Intelligence Service to monitor these allegations, respond to the allegations that were made, and recommend if found that there are people within that service, or anybody for that matter, recommend to the Director of Criminal Investigations, the Inspector General of Police, undertake proper investigations and recommend proper prosecution to the Director of Public Prosecution of all these people.
ICJ says they will continue to champion for the independence of the judiciary as enshrined in law. For Prime Edition, I'm Ben Troy-Njue.